Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byfear. Legendary hand cannons have been, well, sitting at a very interesting place in the meta now for the last couple of months. A lot more players have started using them, especially since the April update came along and nerfed Fawn into the ground. I think a lot more people have been willing to run back to these because they are just very consistent. And for those of you who want to know what I've been using, it's this, the Eyasluna, or the Baby Hawk Moon as some people like to refer to it as. I've been getting a lot of success in the Crucible with one of these, but the majority of my success I think is also due to my roll, as well as this gun just generally being a bit kick-ass. So, the roll I have at the moment has the following bonuses. First of all, we have Hidden Hand. I feel like in mid-air engagements, this is actually one of the best options you can get. Seeing as Icarus affects accuracy and not target acquisition, I actually rate this perk higher than Icarus on my kind of personal preferences. For those of you who are unaware of the difference between accuracy and target acquisition and all that other stuff, basically accuracy is just the cone spread of the weapon, target acquisition is the aim assist. It does allow you also to stay super mobile, and you have a reasonable chance in any engagement where you're in mid-air and you've just got to aim down sights. Normally, of course, this is one of those engagements that only hand cannons have a shot of winning anyway. If you're trying to engage someone at mid-air in auto-rifle, you're just not going to have consistent shot grouping, anything like that. You're screwed from the very beginning, but a hand cannon only needs the three rounds to hit, and it only needs one of them to be a headshot for you to get the three tap, so it's not exactly a terrible idea. Plus, it does mean that you can pull off some of those crazy mid-air gunfights, and you know what? In standard gunfights, it does feel really good anyway. The improvements to aim assist really do help turn a scrub like me into, well, a reasonably competitive Crucible player. So yeah, I think I got one of the better options with Hidden Hand. Next up is Rifled Barrel. This is, in many people's opinion, one of the best perks you can roll on the central column. Yeah, there are things out there, I'm sure, like Quick Draw and Snapshot, although I'm not entirely sure if Quick Draw is now on hand cannons anymore. I think maybe Snapshot isn't either. Regardless, most people will agree that if you're using a hand cannon, Rifled Barrel is one of the top tier perks, and that's kind of for two reasons. First of all, this not only solves a small damage drop-off issue that hand cannons will have, but also it somewhat mitigates the effect of ghost bullets. Range, I believe, is a stat that is somewhat tied to accuracy, so again, the cone that you will see. Which means occasionally you'll aim down sight, shoot a bullet, and it just won't register at all. It's like it's lagged out or just disappeared. Lo and behold, it's not disappeared, it's just the cone spread of the weapon is you engaging them at a certain range and it's not able to actually hit because it's gone wide. I believe that's how ghost bullets work in the current instance anyway. But the point is, Rifled Barrel helps to mitigate those facts quite significantly. I also do think that, well, generally with this you can turn Eyasluna into one of the highest range hand cannons in the game. So, given that it's also one of the nice intermediate ones that can 3-tap someone, that if you do have luck in the chamber can 2-tap someone, it's just a really good option all round. There's no reason not to use it, really. Third on our list, we have Triple Tap. Now, this is not a great PvP perk, but it does help mitigate some of the effects of the hand cannon ammo shortage that players may experience in PvE. If you're skilled enough that you're hitting your headshots consistently and getting the Triple Tap perk to actually proc, you can effectively change your magazine from 10 to 14 or 15 rounds with this perk, and that gives you a lot more longevity. And the perk isn't really enough to carry you all the time, but it is enough to make the difference, I think. And on a primary that you are using in PvE, I feel as though hand cannons are the one kind of weapon that are suited to this, except for maybe higher impact scout rifles, things like the Hung Jury, or maybe if it had it, the Jade Rabbit, Call of Hunter's Duty, those kind of things. So PvE-wise, this isn't a bad perk either. Finally, on my scopes, just for the sake of better target acquisition, I like the Sure Shot IS sight. It is going to improve all of that stuff, but pros out there have told a whole bunch of different things, and frankly, I can't blame them for it, because there's good reasons to choose any of the scopes. Some people really value the Quick Draw IS with hand cannons, and that's purely because of the improvements that you'll get to it in terms of speed. When you do pick up something like, say, the Quick Draw sight, you're going to get a tiny buff to your reload speed, but what it doesn't really advertise very heavily is the improvements to your handling stats. So that's going to be things like being able to aim with it a little bit more nimbly, of course, the faster draw times that you're going to get with it. And most pros nowadays do value speed, especially in the days of shotguns with a Crucible. So in terms of sight, I think it really is up to personal preference, but again, I'm a big noob and I'm not even up at 2.0 KD anymore. So I just like myself a little bit of extra target acquisition, so I know I'm actually going to hit the target. This hand cannon is definitely not the best. If you're going to go ahead and take a look at some of the other crazy Eyasluna rolls out there, you can get ones that have dropped with Rangefinder, there's some I've seen which have dropped with Luck in the Chamber. Reactive Reload is a better perk than people give it credit for. You can two-tap people with both that and Luck in the Chamber, just like you can with Hawkmoon. Other perks on this include things like Outlaw, which is pretty good. Last Resort is a natural pick for Trials players. But all things considered, I'm really happy with this being my go-to hand cannon, and not just for PvP either. Triple tap means that it's a really nice multi-role weapon that I can also bring into PvE as well. So honestly, this is just great. I like the tool that I've been given here. Lots of good reasons to go ahead and use this one. Are there better hand cannons out there? Technically yes, but you do have a few addendums to that technically. You see, whilst Eyasluna is technically rated in Destiny Tracker's PvP weapon rating section as number 8, this is behind all sorts of things, by the way, such as the Hawksaw and, you know, Thousand Yard Stare, you do have it going up against the number 1 slot, which is currently occupied by The Last Word. Now, of course, this is The Last Word. It's always been one of the most competitive hand cannons out there. But the thing is, if you do want to go ahead and use up a exotic slot in something else, like maybe you want to go ahead and bring in the Chaperone like the Fun Police do, or maybe you just want to go ahead and bring in an exotic heavy like Truth and you're very content with using this in your primary for Trials, then I think this is really the hand cannon for most people out there. Eyasluna is really fantastic. If you hadn't already known that, then now you do. But do tell me what you guys are using in the Crucible right now. Personally, I'm switching between all sorts of different things, dependent on map, of course. But for me, my go-tos are this Eyasluna, the Mida, and the Hawksaw. But again, tell me what you guys are using in the Crucible. Is it going to be something completely different from what I've named? Maybe you're someone who just likes to run secondaries and you go with shotgun or just purely sniper. I don't know. Tell me what you guys like to use in the Crucible. And in the meantime, guys, thank you so much for watching. My name is Bife. Purodasia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.